Hey folks, great you're watching again and welcome to this English summary. Well, today we started with some electric work on the Gunner controller. We received the small contacts from Indy, so I made short wires to put in the connector for the controller, and also for the wiring harness for the tank. Well, then we try to power up the system. Some lights were working, but as soon as we connected the gyro and we switched on the power, one of the fuses burned out. So we can say this controller, it's different as the one we need. Or only the connections are different and we have them wrong. So we need an electric diagram for this controller, and then we know for sure if we can use it or not. So that's a little bit of the conclusion we made by that. Dico has been working on the Gunner scope and he applied a layer of black coat, so we can assemble that very soon. Then he has been working on a bracket for the laser rangefinder box. There's this control box near the commander. The original bracket was rusted away, so he made a new one. Let me see, what did we more? I think that's about it about the turret. Well, and then Kaspar came visit us. He is a Volvo mechanic, and he brought us some large batteries. Well, and then we said, okay, let's put them in the BMP and see if we can crank it and see if we can get the water out of the engine. But before we could do so, we need to drain the oil from the engine, because all the oil out of the tank, it's a dry sump lubrication system, all the oil was gone. So it should have gone somewhere, and it was not underneath the vehicle. So we thought it should be in the crankcase or in the sump of the engine. Well, there it was. We drained it. Also, water came out again, and a lot of oil. So then we filled some back into the oil tank. Then we noticed some electric systems didn't work as they did before. Some of the switches were seized. Well, in the end we managed to do it. We could crank the engine. There were some heavy points, but then it looks like the starter has some kind of clutch, because we hear the electric motor turning, but the engine was not turning over. And then in the end, only this electric motor was spinning and the engine was not turning. So maybe we burned out some of a clutch which in there might be. Before we tried to start it, we also needed to put it in neutral. Somehow the gearbox was in gear, because when we wanted to start it, the engine was seized and the vehicle tried to move. So then we tried to push the vehicle forward to get all this tension out of the gearbox to manage to put it in neutral, but it didn't work. And then we used the crowbar to turn the crankshaft. And that did the job, and we could put it in neutral. Okay, so conclusion about that is we need to get rid of that turret over there, and then we can put this one inside. We can clean it, then we can get rid of all the water which is in there. And then we have to find out if we should pull the engine out or not. It's more and more like it will be necessary. There's something really wrong, I guess, because all the oil, it shouldn't be inside of the sump. So it's maybe some broken lubrication line or something like that, or maybe the oil flow back through the scavenger pumps. That shouldn't be possible as well. So there's something wrong with it. Okay. Well, we need to find out. But first we need to get rid of this turret. Well, I think we did the best we could. What about the electric system? Well, we're missing the radio. We're missing a good controller. So, we're done with that, I guess. So we have to arrange a crane pretty soon, then lift it on top of the undercarriage. So we got rid of it for the time till we have the right components and also the main gun, of course, because a lot of people keep asking about the gun. Well, the thing is, the authorities have to pay a visit to us, and then I have to get an invitation for an e-screener test. That's some kind of test to check if you're mentally ill and you shouldn't have a gun. So, but of course, because this corona matter, it is not possible. They do not visit anyone, so that's postponed for no one knows how long. Okay, good, and that's about it. I would say thank you for watching and see you next time.